starting a project is easier and faster in the new Premiere Pro import workflow. When you start off in Premiere Pro, you still have the home screen as before. You just click New Project, and after you click New Project, you get an entirely new way to start off using Media Browser to import. Begin here at the top left. You name your project and select the location where you want to store it. So I'll name this Input Demo and choose a location. Here on the left, you can select media from multiple locations. And here you have a list of favorites as a star next to it. So for instance, here I can favorite this location right here and it goes in the list. And if it's a location that I frequently want to use or for a particular project, I can just make it a favorite and I could select it here in this area. If I want to unfavorite, I just click the star again, but I'm going to use the sample media from Premiere Pro. And notice when I put my mouse over the clip, I can hover scrub through the clip. I can go through all my clips in this particular folder and hover scrub through them. And up here at the top, here we're in the grid view, you can change to the list view. And in the grid view, I can control the size of these thumbnails just by adjusting this slider. I can sort my list here by all these parameters, by name, creation date, ascending order, descending order. I could display my list or my grid by file types displayed. So if I just want to see videos only, that's in my list. I can see audio only or images only. And I can search here by anything in the file name. If I hover over a file name, I get information about the clip, its duration, frame rate, frame size, creation date, all the information about the clip. So if you're at a location on your computer and you're hover scrubbing through and you want this clip, notice here at the bottom, there's a tray down here and it's putting that clip in the tray. And if you put your mouse over it, it'll show you the location of that clip. I'm going to click on one of my favorites locations and I'm going to choose this clip right here. And you notice it is down in the tray. So you can choose media from multiple locations. What I can do down here in the tray is if I select the media and right click and say clear, it is taken out of the tray. I can select an entire folder. Down here in the tray it says 28 objects are selected. I can open up a folder and say I want to go in my footage folder and I want to select everything in here. This way I can say Command or Control A and select all my clips. They're all down here in the tray. If I want to deselect all of those clips in that folder, I say Shift, Command or Control A, and they're all deselected and out of the tray. So now to our import settings on the upper right corner. If none of these options are enabled, in other words, nothing is clicked, and you want to start off as before, all you need to do is add a project name and a project location and say create. You'll have an open project as before. You can import and create your sequence as you did before. But here's some nice options you have now. At the top, copy media. Once you enable this, click on the button, scroll this down. This is great to copy media from another location. Say the location you have selected is a camera card and you've selected a couple of clips here and they're on the camera card. With this option, you copy that media from the camera card to this location. You can choose location. So you only need to copy certain files, not the whole camera card. And this preset here for verification, meaning the media is copied and verified so that you're getting everything that you're asking for. So again, great for copying media from a camera card. You don't have to copy the whole camera card, just what you need. Next is the new bin. It's going to create a new bin in your project area and you can name the bin anything you like here. Call this demo bin. And you have the option to create a new sequence from the media that you selected. So if I select more media and I want to create a new sequence. So now my import settings are, I have four clips selected down here in the tray. I'm going to create a new bin called demo bin. I'm going to create a new sequence called demo sequence. And the thing to be aware of when it creates a sequence, you may have selected media that has multiple frame rates and resolution, but what this interface does, it takes the first clip you selected as the information or your sequence. So this first clip over here, that's where it's getting all its information for the sequence. Then you hit create. And here's my project area. Here's my demo bin with the clips that I selected. Here's my demo sequence. First clip here, all these properties are how the sequence was created. Remember, it's the first clip that you select that determines the properties of the sequence. Since we're here in the edit mode, something new is up here in the workspace area. Now all the workspaces are in this list. Click on this workspaces icon right here. And these are all the workspaces. And right now there's an option that says show workspace label. So this is the workspace I'm on. New workflow workspace. I want to choose, say, learning. That label is showing right there. I go back to the one I was on. There's my workspace. I have another option here. I can show workspace tabs. Now I can grab this bar right here and I can expand it out here. And now it kind of looks like it did before across the top of the menu here. And you can click on any of these here. And if you don't want to see that, you can come back down here and choose show workspace label. And something else that is new for your playback, there's this icon up here, maximize video output. Going to maximize the program window. So if I hit spacebar and play, hit this icon, it is maximized. Hit escape. The way you did it before, maybe you hit your mouse with the program window and hit tilde, something similar, or hit control tilde. Similar ways, but now you have this icon up here, maximize video output. If you want to know more about Premiere Pro, click on one of the videos on the screen now. If you haven't already, like, share, and subscribe. And remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching.